Hi guys, today we are going to discuss about software and hardware. What is software and what is hardware? First of all, what is hardware? Hardware is a physical components of a system. Hardware is a physical components of a system. That means whatever we can touch and see. For example, keyboard, mouse, monitor, the CPU. All these are hardware parts. Okay. Coming to the software. What is software? Software is a set of programs. Whereas program is a set of instructions. Then the software is mainly divided into two types. First one is system software. Second one is application software. What is system software? System software is an interface between users and the computers, the system. It will acting as an interface between users and computer hardware. Coming to the application software. What is application software? Application software is a end user programs. End user programs, nothing but we can work with the applications directly. For example, if you want to create documents, we are going to MS Word and creating documents. If you want to calculate anything, we can open the calculator application and we can perform some calculations. If you want to draw a diagram or draw a painting, you can open MS Paint, paint application, and you can paint it. Like that, n number of application softwares are there in the systems, okay? But what is system software? System software is an interface between user and computer hardware. Without system software, we cannot work with the application software. The application software depend on system software. System software is nothing but operating system. Can you imagine, without operating system, can we work with the system? Can we work with the computers? For example, system softwares, Windows, Unix, Linux, Mac OS. Coming to the mobile operating system. Mobile operating systems are Android, iOS. Can you use your mobile phone without Android? Android is the operating system. All the applications is working based on Android. That means application softwares uses operating system to interact with your mobile hardware. For example, we'll see it's a hierarchy. User will interact with application software. Application software using the system software to interact with hardware. It's a vice versa. Okay. Users can interact with application software. Application software can interact with operating system or system software. The system software can interact with the system hardware. Okay. Next one is what is application software? How to create application software? Application software generally created by programming languages. By using programming languages, we can create the application software. Application softwares created by programming languages. Just we need to understand the concept of language. What is language? First, language is a way of communication. Generally, human to human communication, we are using human languages like Telugu, Hindi, English, Marathi, whatever we know. In that language, we can communicate each other. Then I want to communicate with the system. We know that system doesn't know any language. Only one language it knows, that is called binary language. Then how the binary language will be? In the binary language, only two bits are there, zeros and ones. That's why it's called binary language. Only 2 bits, zeros and ones. Computer knows only binary language, that is zeros and ones. Whereas in our English, A to Z, 26 alphabets are there. Like that, in the binary language only zeros and ones. Whatever the instruction we are giving to the system it's convert into binary language. Okay, programming language. Coming to the programming language. What is programming language? The programming languages are used to develop the application softwares. Application softwares. Generally, we are writing the programs. In any programming language, we are writing the programs by using alphabets, digits, and symbols. It's human understandable code. The human understandable code will be converted into machine understandable code by programming languages. In this conversion also two types, compilation and interpretation. The programming languages are two types again, compilation languages, interpreted languages. Compilation means all the code compiled at a time. That means it will check the Bayesian language, it will check the syntax and semantics, and if the program code is perfect, then it will convert. If any errors are there, it will not convert that code into machine understandable code. For example, in the C language, we are writing a program. We are saving that file as with .c extension. When we are compiling that program, the program will be compiled. When it will be compiled, if the program doesn't have any errors, then it will compile successfully. If it is compiled successfully, then it will create one file which is machine understandable code, that is called executable file. Whenever we run that program, the system will not run our .c extension program. It will run the newly created file with C compiler. Which file is created, that file only run by system. Then the output will be displayed. Okay. This is about C compilation. So interpreted means it will interpret it line by line. For example, HTML is an interpreted language. HTML is an interpreted language. In the HTML or Python, it will give you some 100 lines of code in our program. The first 200 lines, all the lines are correct. Then it will give you the output in compilation language, compilation program, in interpreted program. In first 200, 99th line, we have some error. In this case, compilation programs will not compile your program. Whereas in the interpreter program, it will execute 98 lines and stop at 99th line. This is the main difference between compilation programming and interpreted programs. Okay. Till now, we have discussed hardware, software, and types of softwares, system software, application software, and programming languages, what is language, and types of languages like compilation language, interpreted language. Okay, thank you. Stay at home, stay safe. Okay, thank you.